So Coco is the newest film by Pixar. Pixar always crushes it in the animated department.
For the most part.
This is their newest adventure. It follows a kid named Miguel. Basically, because of this kid's great-great-great-grandfather, I believe. It's either great-great or great-great-great-grandfather. It goes back a little way. Their family has banned music, but he really wants to be a musician, but he's not allowed to. Long story short, his adventure takes him to the land of the dead, where he meets this trickster named Hector, and he needs to meet his musical idol. We're gonna start with this one. We'll start with the animation. First of all, the animation is great. It's like Pixar ups their game every time. The colors are vibrant, the land pops. Something as simple as the bridge to the land of the dead is one of the most magical things you'll see. You're like, I want to walk across that bridge immediately. Sorry, Asgard, your bridge sucks in comparison. Also, the music is very catchy. After my first watch, I didn't find a song that's going to stick in my mind, but generally speaking, the music as a whole was a great ensemble of music. The music was as warm as the tone and theme of the movie, which really is, in the words of the great Vin Diesel,
family.
This movie is all about family and the love and flaws of a family. Every family has flaws, every family has absurdities that you're like, that doesn't need to be there. It doesn't mean the family itself is bad. Such flaws are paved with good intentions, but they should be addressed and assessed, and maybe you don't need to do that. It's just a good look at family. Maybe your family has rules and they're doing those rules. They say they're doing it for you, but they're really doing it for them. Or maybe you have rules for your family and maybe you say you're doing it for them, but you're really doing it for you.
Point is, the quest was a really touching one, and by the end, I was a sobbing, weeping mess. No lies, no BS. Cried in this movie.
I love the characters too. The main kid brought a lot of heart. I have no idea who voices him. I'm gonna look it up right now. Yes, he's been in nothing I've seen, but I imagine I will see and hear more of him. He was great. Also loved Hector. Hector's one of those weasels you meet and you're like, you're kind of a con artist, aren't you? But as the movie goes on, it expands on him and you really see where he's coming from. The movie's not so black and white. It's not like, ah, well, he's just one of those scoundrels. No, the movie really expands on him. He has layers, I'm telling you. The funny thing is, for it taking place in the land of the dead, it's the world that feels the most alive. Never in my wildest imagination have I ever thought of an afterlife being this interesting. I'll take this over to hanging out in a cloud city forever. It really does celebrate the fact or the concept that after life you're no longer bound, and a world like that's really limited by your imagination. And whoever built this world has a huge imagination. And I, for one, am really glad that I got brought along on this adventure and also brought in on some culture that I didn't know much about.
I'm not down with my Mexican death lore, so I knew nothing about it other than the fact that I believe it's the celebration that's happening at the beginning of Spectre.
For me, that's a fantastic thing.
It's Thanksgiving weekend, you need something to do with your family, after you're all stuffed, you go into your food comas and you wake up, what to do? Let's go to the movies, let's watch Coco. Because Coco is definitely worth watching and definitely worth buying on Blu-ray.
Alright guys, so Coco, have you seen it? What did you think about it? Whatever you thought, comment below, let me know. And as always, if you like what you've seen here and you want to see more, click right here to see more.